Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Hi, my dear friends, welcome back. This is the ADC Max. Diagonalize the matrix. This time I consider 2x2 matrix, 3x3 matrix, separate video. So 2x2 first, 3, 1, minus 1, 3. So 2x2 matrix, let's find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So the first step number 1, to find out the eigenvalues. To find the eigenvalues of A. So this is the 2x2 matrix. First of all, it is a real symmetric matrix. Yes, correct. So the row, this is symmetric. So as we know that the characteristic equation is lambda squared minus s1 lambda plus s2 equal to 0. What about s1? s1 is 3 plus 3, 6. Is that right? And what about s2? s2 is 9 minus of 1, 8. 8 is equal to 0. So when we solve this, we get the two eigen values. What are they? Sum of the root is 6, product is plus 8. So I think this lambda plus 2 into, I think it's a minus here, yes, lambda minus 2 into lambda minus 4 equal to 0. Otherwise, the eigenvalues are 2 comma 4. So there are two eigenvalues, is right? So this is the first step. These two are the distinct eigenvalues. Let's find out the corresponding eigenvectors. To find the eigenvectors. Of A. So how to get the eigenvectors of 2x2 matrix, 3x3 matrix? Separate video is there. Please go and watch once again. So A minus lambda I into x is equal to 0 matrix. Subtract the lambda from this. So 3 minus lambda minus 1 minus 1. 3 minus lambda into x. 2x2 matrix, so x1, x2, 0 matrix, 0, 0. Let us multiply, we get it is 3 minus lambda into this. So x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. The next one, minus x1 plus 3 minus lambda into x2 is equal to 0. So this is my star equation. Is it right, sir? Let us substitute lambda is equal to 1. So case number 1, substitute lambda is equal to 2. What we'll get? We'll get, by putting 2 here, 3 minus 2 is x1 minus x2 is equal to 0 minus x1, 3 minus 2 is 1, so plus x2 is equal to 0. I think both the equations are identical, isn't it? Yeah, normally 2x2 matrix, we get the identical equation only. What is that? x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. By that way, x1 is equal to x2. Otherwise, the coefficients of x1 can be cross multiplied here. You get x1 by 1, x2 by 1. So the first eigenvector corresponding to 2 is 1, 1, right? Let us find out the second eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to 4. So substitute lambda is equal to 4. So case number 2, substitute lambda is equal to 4 in the star equation. We get 3 minus 4 is minus x1, minus x2 is equal to 0. Again here, minus x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. Once again, these equations are identical. Isn't it right? These equations are identical. That means that minus x1, always minus multiplying both the sides. So x1 plus x2 is equal to 0. Otherwise, x1 equal to minus x2. So what are the coefficients of x1, x2? I mean, it is minus 1 here. So it is here 1. This is also 1. So 1, 1. So then x2 is 1 minus 1. So once we get the eigenvectors, then the third step is to verify that whether they are pairwise orthogonal. So step number 3, verify that they are pairwise orthogonal. Verify that x1 comma x2 are pairwise. When we say that the two eigenvectors are pairwise orthogonal, let us check it out. The separate video I made for the orthogonal vectors, pairwise orthogonal vectors, length of the vectors, everything. That means that find out x1 transpose x2 equal to 0. What's x1 transpose? 1, 1. What about x2? x2 is 1 minus 1. So it's a product, 1 into 1, 1 plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1 equal to 0. Yes, of course, it is pairwise orthogonal. So what's the corresponding length of the vectors? How to get the length of the vector? Is equal to square root of 1 square plus 1 square. Is equal to root 2. Not only that, find out the
n of x1. What's the n of x1? It's nothing but the normalized eigenvector. What's the n of x1? 1 by its length. 1 by its length. Right? What's the corresponding x2? What is the l of x2? Length of x2? Sum of the squares of the values x1, x2 is equal to root 2. What about the normalization of x2? Is equal to 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2. So I find out the normalized eigenvectors. Why I need this? Because of after verifying that the vectors are pairwise orthogonal, let us go for the step number 4 to construct the normalized model matrix. To construct the normalized model matrix. How to construct the normalized model matrix? Whose column vectors are nothing but the normalized eigenvectors. So 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. What about the second vector, second column vector? This thing but second normalized eigenvector. So 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2. So once I repeat that, normalized model matrix nothing but a matrix whose columns are nothing but the normalized eigenvectors. So the first one is the normalized eigenvectors of x1. Second one is the normalized eigenvectors of x2. That's it. This simple concept. So once we get the fourth step, then the fifth step. What's the fifth step? The fifth step is to get the diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix. Of course, this is the normalized. This n is an orthogonal matrix. If you have any doubts, please kindly check whether it is orthogonal matrix or not. When we say that the matrix is orthogonal, n transpose equal to n transpose n is equal to I. If you have any doubts, please go and verify whether it is orthogonal or not. Now finally, step number 5, to find the diagonal matrix, D is equal to n transpose A n. So D is equal to, what is D? D is equal to n transpose. What's the transpose? This row becomes this column, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. This row becomes the second column, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. Now what's the A? A is given matrix, 3, minus 1, minus 1, 3. What about N? N is as it is this one, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. Now we multiply these three product, which gives the final answer. As we already know, what are the eigenvectors for this matrix? 2 and 4. So I need 2, 0, 0, 4. Let us see that this is the diagonal matrix lambda 1 and lambda 2. 2, 4. How will we get this one? Let's multiply this into this first. What will get? What will get sum? So 1 by root 2 into 3. So 3 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2. Is that right? 3 into 1. 3 by root 2. 1 by root 2 into minus 1, minus 1 by root 2. Okay. Now what about this into this? Minus 1 by root 2 plus 3 by root 2, is right? 1 by root 2 into minus 1 is minus 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 into 3 is plus 3 by root 2. Once again, the second row into this first column. 3 into 1. Yes, 3 by root 2 minus a minus plus 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 into minus 1 minus 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 plus 3. So plus 3 by root 2. So still we have one more matrix here. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus is 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. And before going to that, just I can simplify this. What is the simplification? What's the simplification here? Yeah. So I am coming here. D is equal to, so 3 minus 1, 2. So 2 by root 2, minus 1 plus 3. It's also 2 by root 2. This is 3 plus 1, 4 by root 2. And this is 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 by root 2. What about the A? Still I have the I here. 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2. So once again, one more time multiplication. This into this. So what we'll get? 2 into 1. 2. 2 into 1. 2. Denominator root 2 into root 2 is 2. 2 into 1. 2. So 2 by 2. 1. Again, 2 into 1 is 2. Root 2 by root 2 is, it is 2. 2 by 2 is 1. So 1 plus 1. Got it? Okay. 2 into 1 by root 2 into 1 by 2 is 2 by 2. Right? 2 into 1 by root 2 into minus 1 by root 2. 2 by 2. So it is 0. 4 by root 2 into 1 by 2 is 4 by 2. is 2, and what about this is 2 by 1 by 2 into 1 by root 2, it is 2. So it is 4 into 1 is 4 plus by 2, then what about this 2 into 1, this is 2 by 2 is 2, so what we will get, it is, first row, first column, first row, second column, so this becomes 2, 0, and here 0, so I made some mistakes, let us see here, how we will get 1, I think so, 1 by root 2 into 3 is 3 by root 2, minus minus plus 1 by 2, so it is 4 by root 2, is correct only, so 4 by root 2 into this one, so 4 by root 2, 4 by root 2 here, what about this one, 2 by root 2 is right, so 4 by root 2 is 4 by 2, is 2, yes, 2 by root 2 is plus 2 here, is plus 2, 4 by root 2, let us see, yeah, I think so, here, 1 by root 2 into 3 is 3 by root 2, yes, correct, minus 1 by root 2 is minus plus 1 by 2, is right, 1 by root 2 into minus 1 is minus 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2 plus 3 is minus, so I made a mistake here, minus 3, so minus 1 by root 2 minus 3 by 2 is minus 4 by root 2, isn't it, minus 4 by root 2 here, minus 4 by root 2, so let's multiply now, this 4 by root 2 into 1 by 2 is 4 by 2 is 2, minus 4 by root 2 into 1 by 2 is minus 2, is right, then 4 by root 2 into 1 by 2 is 4 by 2 is 2, then what about minus 1 by root 2 into minus 4 by root 2 minus minus plus 2, so the answer is 2 0 0 4, so what about this, this is nothing but the lambda 1 lambda 2, so this is the Diana matrix B of 2 comma 4, so this is the way to get the Diana matrix by using the step by step procedure, first step to find the eigenvalues, second step to find the eigenvectors, and third step to verify that whether they are pairwise orthogonal, and fourth step construct the normalized model matrix since N is orthogonal matrix, and fifth step N transpose A N, here matrix multiplication little bit care because once you made a plus or minus mistake it is case sensitive, it won't become 0 0, that's why I got struck there, okay, I thought you may understand, you may comfort with this step by step procedure to diagnose the 2 by 2 matrix. The same for 3 by 3 matrix in the next video. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching our YouTube channel ADC Max. Thank you.